Dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, greetings of joy and peace from Northeast India. I am Father Carlos Borowa, talking to you from MSFS Provincial House, Silapathar, Dibrugarh Province, Assam, India. I am indeed very glad to greet you and present this short message on the life of our Holy Founder, Servant of God, Father Peter Mary Mermier. Now let us listen to a scriptural text from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 23, verse 46. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, the biblical text we just listened to is the last words of Jesus from the cross. This says two things about Jesus. First, his resignation to the will of the Father, and second, the sense of fulfillment experienced by Jesus after having completed the mission entrusted to him. In fact, this one sentence summarizes the whole mission of Jesus. Jesus, the beloved Son of God, came into this world to do the will of God. Through his teaching, preaching and healing, he showed us the love that God has for each one of us. And he remained faithful to the mission even to the point of death. And after the completion of his mission, he returned to his abode. When we look at the life of our Holy Founder, we find that in every moment of his life, Father Mermier too sought to do the will of God. Of course, doing the will of God is always a challenge. It's demanding. It can lead one to getting humiliated, rejected, or even face death. Yet, Father Mermier humbly surrenders himself to the holy will of God in everything that he did or undertook or experienced. There are many instances in his life which shows this Jesus-like attitude of Father Mermier. One such incident took place in 1842 when Father Mermier went to Rome to get the approbation of the Holy See for the newly founded congregation. On 16th October 1842, he was received by Cardinal Otteni, the man who could grant him the desired approbation. But the interview didn't go as smoothly as expected. The answer of the cardinal was abrupt and rude. He said, "No approbation can be granted. It's no use to examine the rules." Even in such a humiliating situation, Father Mermier didn't react angrily. His reaction was so saintly, which can be very clearly seen from his letter to the community at La Fayette. He writes, "The beginnings are terrible. However, I praise God. Humiliation will bring success." Father Mermier accepted everything with humility because he was convinced that what he was pursuing was the will of God. And the fulfillment of the will of God demands sacrifice, humiliation, pain, etc. And Father Mermier was ready for that. Another instance is the final years of Father Mermier's life, which was marked by severe physical pain and emotional distress. In 1858, as well as in 1860, he suffered two strokes, which left him, as he himself states, in a situation between life and death. These were the time of agony, powerlessness, acute suffering, and misfortunes of all kinds. He lost his eyesight, and his general health condition too fluctuated between the periods of generally indifferent and bad health. Those who were looking after him or who came to see him were either moved to pity or lost in admiration. For no matter how great the sickness was, the patient's courage and resignation were greater still. One could sense that he was completely submissive to God's good pleasure, even in such a worst physical condition. Father Mermier devoted himself only to prayer and accepted his pain and suffering with holy resignation to the will of God. The serenity with which he went through the last days of his life, the calmness with which he endured the pain, the joyfulness with which he faced the humiliations, shows the true character of Father Mermier, a truly holy person. In everything he adored the design the divine providence had for him. In everything he sought to do the will of God, he remained so serene and calm, even in the face of suffering and death, because he knew what he was doing was for the greater glory of God. He remained faithful till the end. This experience brought a sense of fulfillment in the life of Father Mermier. Life of Father Mermier sets a great example for all of us and teaches us how we too should always seek the will of God and live accordingly. Our joy, happiness, and sense of fulfillment lies in doing the will of God. Our motive should be to please God always and in everything. Only such an attitude will give us a sense of fulfillment at the end of our lives. Let us ask the intercession of our Holy Founder for all the missionaries all over the world. God, our loving and merciful Father, we thank you for the gift of the person of Father Mermier, the founder of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales and Holy Cross of Chavon. Today, in special way, we pray for all the missionaries all over the world. May we also burn with zeal for the mission like Father Mermier. May we always seek the will of God in everything we do, and thus, through our words and deeds, give greater glory to God. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.